Okay, now let's see how to start a new C project by using DevC++ IDE. So first of all, you can double click the shortcut on the desktop and start the DevC++ IDE. So basically this IDE is developed for C++ programming language, but we still can use this IDE to build and run C projects. So to start, we have to go to File and point New. Then you can click on the project. So it will gives you a dialog box to select the programming language and the type of the program that we are going to construct. So from here you can select the project type as C project. So throughout our semester we are using C programming language, so we can make the C as our default programming language by ticking this make default language. So normally every programmer start with the well-known initial computer program known as Hello World program. So it just simply gives the output as Hello World. So this will be our Hello World program. So I will name this project as Hello World. So normally in a project name, it is better not to have spaces. Therefore, you can use underscore or first letter capital method. So to separate two words, use the first letter capital. Then you can clearly identify the words separately. Now we have to use select the application type or the program type. So from here we have to select console application, as we are not going to look into Windows Forms application. So our course is a introduction course to programming. So for basic level we are using console applications. Therefore you will write the program by using basically a text editor. So in your output you will receive your output in the MS-DOS prompt. So that is the idea behind this console application. You don't see a nice graphical interface in your program, but you will see a basic text based outputs, but you can use the most of the processes or the calculations which are available in windowed mode as well. So choose the console application, then press OK. Then it will ask for a place to save your program, right? So it is always use a dedicated place to save your practicals for this subject. So in this example, I will select the desktop and I will create a new folder to store my project. So I will name this folder as practical 1. So inside the practical one folder, I will save all the documents related to practical one. So you can also use same folder structure throughout this course till the end of the semester. So you will end up with a lot of practical folders. So now I'm in the practical one or the practical one folder in my desktop. So there this project will saved by the given name, which is Hello World. The extension is DEV. So I will save it. So now what happens is it will open the text editor. So in this text editor, some basic codes or the mandatory codes are automatically generated, right? So I will keep this text editor away for a moment and I will go to the desktop. So inside my desktop, I have this practical one folder. Inside my practical one folder, what I can see is the project file. So this is helloworld.dev. This is the project file. So this file will be opened by using dev c developer IDE. Basically, this is the project file. So our program has not been saved yet. So I will save this program. So I can go to file, save, or I can use this save all icon. So it is better to use save all icon rather than save, but in this example it doesn't make any difference, but I will click the save all. Then it will ask for another file name and a location to store this C file, .c file. So the file is automatically named as main.c, which means this is our main source file. So this in this source file, the instructions or the computer program will be saved. So this C file you can open in any text editor. So if you open the C file, you can see set of C commands or the a designed program in C language. So I will save this main.c in my practical one folder. You know it is saved. Now if I move to my folder, the practical one folder. So now I have three files. Right. Now I have the C file and there's another layout file created by the IDE or the DevC++ IDE. So actually we are not going to consider those .dev and .layout files. What matters are the main.c file. When we compile the program, we will get another set of files. We will look at those files. Okay. Now, actually, in this dev C++, some codes are already generated for you. So, as I mentioned earlier. So this program actually run and do nothing, which means you won't get any output. So this program is written to run and terminate successfully, but it doesn't compute anything, it doesn't calculate anything, and it doesn't provide any